Wow, all right. We got people in the rafters. This is awesome. I like looked out through the curtain like 5 minutes ago and there was a bunch of empty spots. I was like, where is everybody? Probably outside smoking, right? Or something. I'm so excited. The people watching the show at home already got to see all the names flying through space, so they know who's coming out here. I just periscoped four of the guests backstage, but you guys don't know, so let's just cut to it already. Please give a big warm welcome to Morgan Murphy, Geoff Tate, Kenny and Keith Lucas, and Pete Holmes.
Sitting on a stool instead of the chair.
Sit wherever you want. But, we make sit a better, somewhere. You're not even high yet. Like you can't make a decision.
Yeah, but I don't like being this far from Doug. It freaks me out.
That's the seat.
Pete has to be close to me.
You're so funny. It'll be great.
We're gonna make you move down later in the show, Pete.
That's fine.
You can't sit in the alpha position the whole time.
I forgot that you did that, and I like that a lot.
Yeah, we can rotate. Yeah.
Well, let's start on the other end and say hello to everybody. Morgan Murphy is here, you guys. What?
I don't like this chair.
Why? What don't you like about it?
Hey, he switched with
still.
Me. I don't like my chair.
Is
we
that
want
true?
To switch
I
chairs.
I bet you they're very similar.
It's a visual gag.
You're going to dislike them equally.
I really don't like.
What is it that you don't like about it, Pete?
Mine's wobbly.
It moves mine? Without you telling it to move. It's the Ex Machina chair. It has its own consciousness.
I think that's better for the
What if we just move to these
crazy.
Stools?
Yeah, right? Oh, yeah, these stools.
Then we can just sit on these stools.
You can sit on a hot stool if you want. Look at that. How's that feel? You like that?
Is it gonna be good there? Is that?
Well, I think it'll be good. There you go.
I feel better about that.
Okay, right,
welcome to Getting Doug with High. I'm Doug Benson. To my left are the guests. Let's smoke dope.
We're gonna start smoking in a few minutes. We gotta wait for the alarm to go off.
I'm just letting you know I'm going back. Okay, what? Sorry.
What's going on?
I just went back to. I just was gonna let you know I went back to my chair.
You all right. Did?
Yeah.
Any other chair movements you do, I don't need to be appraised of.
The stool is great, I feel level.
Let's say hi to Geoff Tate, everybody. Geoff Tate is here. Hot off a Doug Loves Movies yesterday in Minneapolis. Yeah. That will be available for people to listen to on iTunes probably now-ish.
Hot off the.
Yeah, we had to fly. We had to get up early this morning to fly back to LA to do this. How you feeling, Geoff? Are you tired?
Yeah, I feel like I did all that stuff you just said.
Yeah, and when you smoke today, you think you're gonna go pretty sleepy on us?
No, I'll be fine for sure.
You'll be high energy like Pete?
No one's like Pete.
No one is like Pete, and that brings me. Oh, it's 4:19. So the vapor bags are coming out.
Oh boy.
I've been waiting for
this is an urgency. It's a made up thing.
We gotta smoke at 4:20, Pete.
According to who? Who are these rule givers?
I don't know, but you seem bigger than you've ever seemed to me right now.
This room is
you're
very
so,
big.
I'm gonna have to sit on that kind of stool just because it's too weird looking up at you like that. See how this is more normal?
Yeah.
Well, it's not really normal. It's like we're on a train or something. The Lucas brothers are here, you guys. That's right. Back on the show, all repeat guests, all great smokers in the past, so I know everyone's going to do great today.
You guys blaze the crunt?
Okay. Oh,
of course,
man.
What is that? What's crunt? The crunt?
Oh, yeah. Crunt. I just said crunt. I don't know what crunt is. What's crunt?
Chronic.
Oh,
chronic.
Right. Yeah, of course.
Why did you say chronic? Ridicle. Chronicles of Riddick.
sober.
Yeah, wait till we get that weed out here. It's 4:20. Is there any chance we could get those bags out here?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it's a live show, so we have to do the vaping.
Oh. Well, it's in front of an audience in a theater that has fire laws, so we theoretically can't smoke in here.
How much of this do I, I'm not
just as much that it would be passed along quickly.
Okay, okay,
yeah,
all
yeah.
right.
Because we, it's 4:20. I know I want to smoke. Oh, here we go. Thank you.
Ooh.
Thanks, Denisa.
How many people in the audience have fucked the Kron just today?
Isn't that fun that there's some people that didn't clap? Like, yeah, hey, let's just go watch some people get high. We don't need to participate. That's we don't need to crash cars when we watch Fast and Furious. You know what I mean?
That's really good.
Thanks.
I know. Really good.
I don't like this. Oh, that was way too much.
Double laugh.
Where's the monkey lighter? It's so heavy.
Finally, he said it. I think this bag is might have been filled too early.
It looks like he's
it's, oh, that's better.
Oh, that's much better, man.
You say that one? Like that one's better.
That look? Would you say it looks like you have this ball pack when you get it?
Yeah. Okay. You want me to say that?
Yeah, yeah. But wait till you have both of them.
I think I got my lip gloss on them. I apologize.
Yeah, yeah. So time it out. There
you guys. Taste.
We're definitely going to need to put you on the other end after the break.
Yeah, for sure.
Because I can't even hear Morgan.
You put us in order of energy.
What about that?
Very interesting.
You got to say what he just said.
Oh, this looks like Hugh Hefner's ball sack.
Where Yes And was born, Yes And shall live.
Here at the UCB Theater.
Established 2015.
Yeah.
Pete, is that how improv is done? Where you're like someone just thinks up both sides and they're like, now you do it. Is that improv? That's what Del Close taught.
That's the best improv, is just doing what you're told.
The best Mexican improviser studied under Del Taco.
Oh, man.
It looks like you right now. You know, see what it's like.
Yeah.
So like a 3 is a 10, because that joke is a 10, and it got a 3, so a 3 is a 10.
Well, how do you build? You got to start low and then build.
That's what I'm saying. These guys, we're friends.
But what did you say to me right before the show started?
I said I'm worried I'll freak out because of twins.
Are you freaking out?
Not yet.
No, but he will. He's gonna freak out.
Our goal is to scare people. That's what we do.
Hey, here's a fun game for you.
Yeah.
Guess which one is Keith and which one is Kenny?
That's Keith.
Wrong.
You gotta commit, right?
You do.
Yeah. Why be like, ah?
We gotta remember that Keith wears the Ronald Reagan button.
Okay.
And I got Barry.
You could do more.
It could be something less subtle than a Ronald Reagan button.
I mean, for identical twins, you're very identical. You know what I mean? Like, I know Jason and Randy, and I can tell them apart.
Yeah.
After, give me a little time. I'm starting to see it.
Yeah.
I'm starting to see it.
But you're pretty. Make it easier.
Yeah, but, you know. Like, what if I'm like, hey, guys! And just for a second, I can't tell.
Yeah, it could happen. That's...
They definitely use the same beard clipper.
No, we don't shave. We don't shave.
Yeah.
You don't
so it's just similarly scraggly on both of y'all. Yeah.
Mine is not thicker.
Oh, I think maybe it is now that you mention
it. Thicker.
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, when did you guys decide to be twins?
That was like 2 years ago. 2 years ago, man.
That's pretty rough.
Yeah.
That's great.
I realized that this is what God wanted.
You guys met at the 22 Jump Street.
Yeah. How'd you know?
Well, they were like, you all look the same. Can you talk at the same time? They're like, fuck yeah, we can.
Fast money.
And then everything's great, but you're a real staunch Republican and you
very gold order.
Very liberal, so I bet that's real fun.
You're both Republican?
No, I'm a Republican.
I'm not a Republican.
Look, turns out I don't know who Goldwater is.
Yeah, like,
are you no Goldwater?
No, I'm only 36.
I'm younger than that. It doesn't matter.
But you have the butt.
That's right. That's right.
Oh, there's another bag? So many bags.
It looks like Hugh Hefner's ball sack after the orgy. I mean, see, that was like a 7. Because if you get a 2 at 4:20, in this theater.
Well, it's just that it wasn't better than the first one.
It wasn't better than the Del Taco riff. I completely agree. It's just fun to be with friends, you know what I mean?
new friends,
if you
old
watching
friends.
At home, it's fun to pretend you're with friends.
I'm saying you're like watching, you're like, nah, man.
Yeah.
This is you with your pipe, because you're not in a fire code. No, like a one.
They probably wouldn't mind if we lit something up here, but we're just trying to play by the rules.
Ceilings are not get anybody in trouble. 22 times too high.
The ceiling here?
Yeah.
Is why?
22 times too high.
What does that mean?
They're too high.
Is 22 times too high? What are you saying?
There's how high they should be. Multiply that by 22.
Oh, they're 22 times too high.
I think you already are 22 times too high.
Oh, man, new catchphrase. I'm 22 times too high, man.
Don't think that's gonna catch on. What will catch on, I think, is a black shirt with a lot of cat hair on it. Or is that dog hair? Is it dog hair?
It what is kind dog of, hair.
It's dog hair. You're covered in dog hair.
Yeah.
It's very distracting to me.
I had to wrestle him before he left the house to prove that I'm the alpha. You know, like he's always thinking he's in charge, and then right before I leave the house, I'll sabotage him.
There's no doubt that you're the alpha on the stage right now, for sure. But Geoff is making a move.
Oh.
Geoff's making a move. Why are you walking it all the way across?
And when this comes to you, say it looks like Lance Armstrong's ball bag.
That's good.
Improvisation.
It's real easy to do, you guys. You just do what Pete says.
Oh, man, it looks like Lance Armstrong's ball bag.
I would have given that line to the Lucas Brothers as well.
Tastes like it, too.
Tastes like it.
Tastes like a Tour de France kind of after. Tastes like an after.
I believe it's so far.
Another fucking bag.
More?
What?
Another bag.
So far, it's all sativa so far, I think.
Oh, good.
And yeah, that'll be,
I don't like that indica.
That'd be a blue dream.
What's that?
I don't dislike indica. I just don't want to get too sleepy.
I understand.
Yeah.
Wait, what's the sativa?
Blue dream.
Blue dream?
Yeah. Who named the weed?
Yeah, God. I guess, you know, the person first makes the strain gets to slap a name on it, I guess. And but then there's similar names, you know, like people just sort of use the same name for stuff.
That's
it can be confusing. But the indica, when we get to it, if we get to it, is going to be Clinton OG.
Oh, I like that.
That's a good name.
Oh.
Yeah.
Was Bill Clinton, like, known as a sleepy guy?
Not really. I don't think so.
Yeah, this keeps coming back.
It could be Hillary Clinton.
Yeah,
there's two of them.
Not necessarily two.
That's probably where you're getting confused. There's two. Oh, man. Oh, Geoff Tate, you're the best.
All right.
All right. Let's see what happens.
How you feel? How you guys feel? Good?
I'm doing great.
Yeah, I'm doing all right.
I'm pretty good.
I feel.
That's terrifying to me. I find that very scary. Why are you laughing in that manner?
That's a good laugh.
That's not good.
That's what this whole
what?
Thing is.
What?
Is this not working on me? Is this like?
Yeah, let's freak
clearly?
Out Pete Holmes. Is what the show is this episode.
Hey, what are you laughing about?
Wait, what are you laughing?
Yeah, see, there's a real element here.
What is it? What is the laugh?
What are we laughing?
I'm
laughing?
Laughing a little bit because if there's something about this that feels unladylike. Is that weird? Is that girls?
Audrey Hepburn never did this.
No.
Hey, Morgan, come sit over here. I'm over here.
Yeah. Really?
Hamhauser.
Yeah, you're
over there. Go over there.
But wait a second, Pete. You never saw the movie Hempfest at Tiffany's?
I knew that. We're playing comedy football, and you told me to go long, and then you threw the scoring touchdown joke. I guess you have to be
so we're done?
High
That's
for
it?
That to make sense.
I done.
Hi, Morgan Murphy, everybody. I know I introduced her already, but it's fun that she can be heard by me now, and I her.
And I you.
Shout out. Shout out to Washington, D.C., our friends in Washington, D.C., who they are the most viewers per capita of our last episode. They keep popping up there. That's D.C.'s fifth appearance and second time in a row. So the show's very popular in D.C. So
should we clap for D.C.?
I guess. I don't know.
Yeah, good.
Just like to don't think they're doing anything else, right? Yeah. So, Washington, D.C. Yeah, you heard me.
That explains the clowns in Congress.
That's a bad joke we were making. It wasn't real, though. I did fake voice.
It's weird, man.
What? We're out of bags.
We're out of bags.
Oh, these guys want more.
We want more.
Awesome. I come here to smoke, man.
Yeah.
I love it.
I saw a homeless guy I know at my pot shop the other day.
Oh, my God.
Another bag.
Came outside. He was sitting on the sidewalk, right? I was walking by him, and I was like, hey, you want a joint? Because he seemed like he bought a real little bit of pot because he's homeless. And he said, oh, yes, thank you. And I've never heard him have a word with anyone other than himself. And he said, oh, yes, thank you. And I had a little doggy with me, and he was so sweet. He goes, you know why I sweep the streets? And I thought it was because he was crazy. He said it was because all these little doggies don't wear shoes.
Well, now he's not homeless because he lives in my heart.
Pete, did you pick the number 22 earlier as a reference to Keith and Kenny?
I don't understand.
They're the stars of 22 Jump Street.
Oh, man.
We're
the best part of 22 Jump Street. Fuck Nick Offerman. We love Nick Offerman. We love him. That was a joke. He is the man. Isn't he great?
No.
We're both bad.
Yeah. Oh, okay, good.
But fast acting. Fast acting to Nactin.
Tough acting.
We never said fast. I'm from the Tenactin family.
Pete Holmes is your stage name. Your real name is Pete Tenactin.
I'm heir to the Tenactin fortune.
No wonder you're so cocky about your work. You can fail all you want, right?
Trying to put the right foot forward.
Family joke.
Oh my God. I'm bringing an arc out. Doug, if you brought an arc out, would feel more connected.
I'm arcing out.
You're Alan arcing out. Can you bring it out a little
bit? I don't want to arc it out too much because we've got folks sitting over here. I'm trying to give everybody a little bit of a view.
Right. Can I speak for this section? Who gives a shit?
Fuck those people.
When Pete performs in the round, he just picks a spot and goes. Does not turn around once. That'd be funny to go out to a thing in the round and never turn around. I did a show once where the stage turns while you're on it, so you could just stand there and everyone would get to see your face.
That's dope.
I was opening for Tim Allen.
Oh, where?
Yeah. So it was a long time ago. He was, you know, he was hot on Home Improvement, and I was in town. I was in the same town doing a show somewhere else, and they needed an opener last minute. I ran over there and stood on a disc that spun and told jokes to people who like Tim Allen.
It wasn't
a weed crowd, is what I'm saying.
But you're spinning.
It was a cocaine crowd. Because that's what he used to sell before he went to jail. Don't sell cocaine, you guys. I like to put a message in every once in a while. But Tim Allen couldn't be a nicer guy, by the way.
If you're coming to a Getting Doug with High show to figure out whether or not you should sell cocaine, not doing so good.
This might be fun. Hang on a sec, just one sec. Catch. Yes!
That's very nice.
I had a feeling that would be fun, and then it was. Morgan?
No, just when you sell, like, so you get in trouble for selling cocaine, yes, you go to jail. Do you get in less trouble if you say you were giving it as a gift?
Yeah, you do. Intent to distribute. No, that doesn't specify. No. We never said fast.
Who are you asking for, a magi?
I'm just curious if you get less jail time if you're like, oh, I'm in here for giving somebody a present.
Well, that's the, like in a lot of states where weed is decriminalized, it's still illegal to sell it. You could smoke it, you just can't sell it.
Of course you do.
So
no, for you.
I think a lot of gifts are being given in those situations. You know, like I'll give you the gift of $100 and you give me the gift of eighth. That kind of thing.
Yeah.
Let's gift each other on this situation.
I just bought a pot Keurig. Well, not. I guess they're not made by Keurig, but they work in the machine.
What?
Yeah, K-cups.
You take a cup of pot?
No, you take a cup. It's coffee. It's pot coffee.
Oh, okay.
And you put it in your Keurig machine.
But they make it so it works in the Keurig machine.
Yeah.
All right. They're probably thrilled with that development, the folks at Keurig. Maybe they'll advertise on our show now.
Yeah. Coffee and weed at the same time is kind of like, why don't you just do nothing?
Yeah.
Do the tenactins interact with the Keurigs at all? Could you,
Tenactin? Does this joke make sense? I'm asking all you comedians.
Okay, here we go.
Help me make this joke make sense.
Okay.
Do it.
You're so fast, when you're in prison, people smuggle you regular cakes.
I see how you tried to make it funny by laughing at it to yourself
at
the end.
I'm laughing at it for real. No, if anyone can explain to me what I mean by that joke.
Why doesn't anybody laugh at that?
Instead of having something inside it?
Yeah, you're so fat someone smuggled a cake inside a gun. Like that.
Like
the opposite.
Like a smaller cake in a bigger cake.
Oh, that's good. That's
like they're sneaking a giant cake that like a stripper will jump out of, but once you open it, there's just more cake in that. Because Pete Holmes is so fat in prison that he needs two cakes.
It's another joke, man.
That was like a web series. I took too many turns.
This is amazing. I've never seen a situation where a couple of black guys hang back on the "your mama's so fat" jokes.
You know,
dive right in. You already know them all.
I heard them all. Yeah, it's like.
What do you think of Pete's? Is Pete's salvageable?
Okay, wait.
Are you telling this to black people or?
No. I'm not telling it to black people.
Okay.
Are you gonna tell it? Are you gonna tell it on that show where they make fun of prisoners?
I thought you meant your
Geoff Ross's thing.
Did he make fun of prisoners?
Yeah, the show Say It to Their Face or whatever it's called.
I felt like I was straight.
No, there's a show where Geoff Ross goes to prison and just burns all these people.
Oh, no, that was he did a special, yeah.
You should have opened with that, Geoff, instead of talking about it like everybody knows exactly what you're talking about. You know on TV where the guy makes fun of the prisoners? Hogan's Heroes?
That is a they're already in prison. Yeah. Most people, you know, you get roasted by Geoff Ross, you go home, you're like, to your house, and you're like, oh man, he got me.
Yeah.
This guy's just laying down in his cell like, oh man, this is impossibly worse.
Yeah, Foxworthy gets on his own Foxworthy airplane, and this guy's like,
how are you?
I was just fighting in the shower.
Hey, just try to look out at the audience or everyone, or you know what I mean? Don't just have a conversation with Pete on the end.
Yeah.
And,
I was trying to tell you that. We're going to rank it as a Yo Mama joke.
Okay.
Yo Mama's so fat, when she's in prison, people smuggle her files filled with cake.
Too many words.
Files.
Files is maybe too antiquated of a reference that people don't think of. These guys that just got out of the jail, the prison, they didn't use files.
I know.
What'd they use?
It's an old school kind of reference.
The internet. That was so funny, man.
That's great.
The internet, and it was only for you. Yo Mama's so old, I told her to act your age and she died. That's my favorite. It's very short. You don't hear a lot of so olds.
It's more succinct.
Succinct?
You don't hear a lot of olds.
It's like, it's a good one.
Yeah, why is that insulting that someone's mama is so old? Like, why is that something they're doing wrong?
Kind of
she's
sad.
Gross and
a fat person can go on a diet, but an old person is fucked.
Your mama's so old, she clearly took care of herself.
Yeah. Your mama is so old, it's impressive.
Yeah. I like your mom is so old.
Yeah.
Everybody knows the weird kid with the two old parents.
His name is Pete Tenactin.
My parents are old as fuck. What about this one?
Mine are too.
Really? Yeah. Mine's like 70-something, 76.
My dad's 75.
Yeah, there you go.
My dad's 75. I'm not just going to say it to Pete. Yeah. My dad is 75.
What about this one? Your mama's so ugly. People break into her house just to close the shades.
Oh, that's good.
That's a good one.
That's a good one.
It's a good one, right?
That's good.
And is ugly an acceptable target? I'm asking Doug, who said old wasn't good.
I don't know.
Well, I don't know about
ugly. Speaking I mean, ugly old, also, they you can't really fix it.
The saggy titty.
Okay, there you go.
Saggy titty.
Saggy titty. Ugly is definitely accepted, for sure. I guess so.
What I don't like about the show is you get us really, really baked, and then it's over. And then I'm just this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
it's like a 45-minute show, and you're like, let's go to the outer space! And then it's just going to be me trying to pay a bill online.
I got things that I want to do with this show, and I'll start saying one of them, and we'll see how long you can go without interrupting.
I'll do my best.
Let's see if you can hang back a little bit. Pretend like you're the next guest and you're just waiting to come on. I swear I'm gonna get him and Todd Glass on the show together at some point.
That'd be great.
Yeah, only one of them will get out alive without him. And I will feel in prison. Speaking of Geoff Ross in prison, when he came on Getting Dug with High, he got so high, all he could do was sit there and make roast jokes.
Really?
Like, he could not have a conversation. All he did was make jokes about my jacket and the set.
That's how, if, like, Geoff Ross was in the hospital and he was getting better, like, that's how you'd know he was really better. He was like,
Geoff's roasting again.
It's in the Christmas letter. Geoff told me I have poor makeup. He's better.
Remember when I said I had a thing I wanted to do? That's what's gonna happen. I have to accept that.
You take these pauses, and the pauses are so tantalizing.
I don't take pauses.
You just took one.
When?
When I was speaking.
Yeah.
Premium.
That's the problem. Is people always hear pauses. Even when you're speaking, there's a pause happening.
I need to, that's like Neil Simon Play level. That was better than anything you'll see on Broadway. That was better than Cats. That's the name of my new album. I'm going to call it Only Hear Pauses.
You can tell he's high when he walks more than when he's sick.
That's true.
He walks high.
Look, I'll try and walk normal.
Last summer,
it's like I think you're all cops. Hi.
Hey, where are my signals going to come from?
Oh, shit, it's at high.
Okay. Remember, I'm going to talk about you for a second. That should hold your attention.
Okay.
All right. last summer in Montreal, do you remember when you did the Opie and Jimmy show?
Yeah, and everybody bullied me.
No. Do you remember? Let's name together who else was on that show, all at the same time.
Bill
it was
Burr.
You, the guy who just spoke to Obama, Mark Maron.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
He interviewed Obama for What the Fuck?
Yeah. Yes.
Yep.
Well, he wins.
Yep. The President of the United States is going to chat with a guy after he just intro'd the show by saying, "What the fuck, fuckers?" I'm here with President Obama.
Holy shit.
It's amazing.
Holy shit, I can't
He already
believe
did it. It's already done. It comes out on Monday.
In the garage. In this place, right? Didn't you do it in this place?
Oh, I thought you were just saying your favorite Weezer song.
No, I think that's
they did it in the garage.
That
they
gave to you.
You can't do it in the garage.
That's what they did.
If you're the president, you can't go in garages.
But in the garage is where I feel safe.
That's where they pull the car around. One guy.
All right, who else was on that panel? Judy Gold.
Bill Burr, Nick DiPaolo.
Dave Attell. Ari Shaffir.
Oh. Ari Shaffir.
It was 10 comedians and two guys that host the show and Pete Holmes. And I watched an hour of it, and that whole hour was about Pete Holmes.
I don't remember.
So we
that.
Have no chance. Yeah.
It was, you were on fire and just bouncing off 9 other people.
I am so impressed. I have no memory of that. I'm going to have to check that out.
I'm pretty sure I walked up to you and put my hand on your shoulder when it was over, like I would just witnessed a miracle.
Well, Jesus fed the, 3,000. I did 9 comedians.
All right, with that, we'll be right back.
It's a miracle.
We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
Somewhere in California, this may all be happening. Right now.
Sweet home San Diego.
Film Signal and Doug Benson, the team that brought you the greatest movie ever rolled. Now bring you an adventure with very little adventure in it. Chronicon. A story of a boy, a plant, and a convention. It's a sprawling saga.
We gotta get out of the way of the train.
It's a spectacular spectacle.
Where in the world is Morgan Spurlock?
Morgan Spurlock!
I want to find him, confront him.
Morgan!
It's an epic of weirdos.
Don't get so close to me, weirdo.
What?
In your mouth.
And weirder hoes.
Remember the fat man with the happy smoke?
This is a joke, I can smell it!
And aliens from all over the Earth. Chronicon, episode 420, a new dope, 2 or 3 years in the making, and it's coming to your galaxy this summer.
We're back! Yeah! Weed, yeah! That was an ad that you just saw, the trailer for Chronicon episode 420, a new dope. And it's available for pre-order on iTunes, and it's available on VOD on July 3rd, just in time for this year's Comic-Con. If you can't go and you feel sad about it, just watch me running around down there trying to get high with superheroes.
I'm doing a podcast.
What's that?
I'm doing a podcast. You should come do it.
During Comic-Con?
Yeah.
I'm going to be in Pittsburgh that weekend, because I thought, what's the opposite of Comic-Con? And
I misunderstood.
What? I'll be down there though. On Wednesday I do Doug Loves Movies. And then Thursday I'll be hanging around, and then Friday I go to Pittsburgh.
Oh, okay, cool.
I cut out a Comic-Con before it gets all crowded.
What are you gonna call the Empire Strikes Back one?
That's not the order of things. I don't need to do that. But if I did I'd call it Empire Strikes Back. We were Or Revenge of the Spliff, or every single one of them has a version that I could say, but that we just went with a new dope because Morgan Spurlock's thing was called Comic-Con Episode 4, and A New Hope.
Return of the Jed High.
You're good at this.
Did you see I did the joint gesture?
Yeah, we got it.
Return of the Jed High.
I'll come to you for all the names for all the products that I put out there, because I got to get into the game now. I'd have a bunch of shit with my name on it.
Really?
Yeah.
Merchy?
You know, like maybe instead of Pokeball, they'll be willing to change it to Benson-a-bowl. Makes no sense. But I didn't want to say Poke Benson. Very much against that. How are the Lucas brothers doing?
I'm gone, man.
Fucked up, man.
Yeah.
I love it.
I wish I could give more.
That's an immediate dream come true.
Yeah. I can fill those gaps.
I wish there was more water, and I'm getting some.
I'm here for you.
Do you guys get twice as high because you're both smoking?
I don't know, man.
Do we get twice as high?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We get twice as high.
That just scared me that you didn't know.
That I didn't milk?
Covering the
that
mystery.
He didn't know.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, why did I mumble that so hard?
You guys should do the bit where he smokes and then you exhale and then everyone laughs.
You didn't want to do it in the next commercial break when we come back. You could do the whole bit, and people who tune in at that point will be blown away.
Wait, what are we doing again?
I think Schmock and Vallely did that.
No, me and Justin Willman did it on that midnight.
What are we doing?
He pretended to take, he took a hit and I blew it out.
What am I doing?
Yeah, I guess it is happening now, and I'm somehow the coach. I'm your bit coach. Okay,
I'll do it now.
Hold it. And don't exhale.
Fuck it, do it now!
Don't exhale till I say go. Ready? Smoke!
That's fun.
That was good. And then he exhales for no reason.
Yeah. You're a great coach, man.
Thanks, man.
Yeah. I like Bit Coach as your new coach.
Thanks for stopping by, comedy conductor. Let's do some pot topics.
Hot topics.
Delaware. Let's hear it for Delaware, everybody.
Delaware.
Thank you, Delaware. Thank you, India. Delaware officially became the 18th U.S. state to decriminalize marijuana. A nice governor by the name of Jack Markell signed into legislation, the legislation into law on Thursday. 6 months from now, Delawareans can possess up to an ounce of marijuana and use the drug privately, although police can confiscate it. So that's going
to
be...
If they're about to watch Tropic Thunder.
That's going to be a problem.
Wait,
I agree, man. That's fun, silly time.
You don't get to agree with the thing you say.
Yeah, they can confiscate it for what?
It's a fair point.
That's what I'm saying. So I bet you there'll be issues with, you know, cops taking weed from people, probably, you know, race-oriented.
But at least they're upfront about it.
Just because they can get away with it.
I mean, cops take things away from people all the time, and this law just has it in it. Like, we could do it.
Also, yeah.
You do that a lot.
But, already. You know, to just walk away, I give it to them every time, you know?
Yeah.
To just walk away. Or a $100 fine is what they can give you, a $100 ticket for it.
That's not bad.
Yeah, so see you soon, Delaware. I'm in.
As a name, Delaware kind of lays there.
What?
It just kind of lays there.
Yeah, you could never, Delaware could never be the punchline of something.
That's right.
Oh my God, I was in Delaware. Well, yeah,
unless
so,
it was like,
sounds all right.
Delaware, were you?
That's the good
Delaware, what the fuck?
Jack on Delaware, what the fuck?
Barack Obama.
President Obama. Wait, how much is Mark going to talk about himself while talking to President Obama?
Oval, I mean, why's it got to be oval? Oval's freaking out.
He's got to tell him that he was in political radio for many years and how he followed it. You know, it'll be all about Mark's journey of watching Obama.
His first question is, have you seen Almost Famous? I chased the bus in Almost Famous. Lock the gate. That was me.
Who locks your gate?
Yeah, so have you ever had to scream lock the gates?
I bet you he has, actually.
I did once in Almost Famous, adamandeve.com.
That was great.
Della what?
Della what the fuck?
I forgot I was on this show the whole time Pete was talking.
What about when you were talking just now?
Nah, I was killing it.
Arizona, you guys, no deaths. That's the name of this pot topic.
No death.
Wait, people don't die.
No one died in Arizona.
I don't think anyone that's doing any of the technical stuff on the show can possibly be not a little high right now. Because we've smoked so much, the people bringing us the weed have just given up. They can't even fill the bags fast enough.
Oh, man.
Yay, thank you. Oh, boy.
Is that an indica?
Oh, yeah, can we get an indica? And can you tell us, can you indicate when it's an indica? Or you'd rather not? What are you saying?
Do you guys have any of that coffee Morgan has?
I bet you they've slipped some in already.
Morgan, what'd you say?
Morgan's got
what's that, Jeff? What?
Some of that pot coffee, is it? If we're making coffee.
Oh yeah, pot coffee.
Ordering pot, I'll get the coffee one.
Yeah, I'm not really in the mood for coffee right now, and this weed's hitting me just fine.
Yeah.
Arizona.
There we go, Arizona.
Has had medical marijuana for 5 years, or if you have your card or whatever, it's cool. And they announced this week, the health department officials there announced this week, they have no evidence that marijuana has been the cause of any death in the state over 5 years. Yeah, I don't know why they had to do a study.
Yeah.
Because that would have been in the news, you know, and Nancy Grace would never shut up about it. Pot death in Arizona!
That was like a Studio 60 skit.
Yeah, but it was a rebuttal to some dumb... some woman published an op-ed that claims that 62 kids died in marijuana-associated deaths in Arizona. And that's just crazy. That was all drunk driving, I'm sure. I'm sure of it. 1,544 people just heard that powerful message I just put out there into the world. And while we're at it, shut down SeaWorld. So, what?
Vincent, what if you're drunk and high, they go, oh, that guy was drunk.
Dry.
What happened?
That guy was totally DNH. No, they always, like on the news, they always say there was alcohol and drugs in their system, or alcohol and weed in their system.
Right.
And they always drag weed into it, mm-hmm. and the alcohol is the problem. If anything, the weed probably kept them on the road for, you know, a few blocks further.
Right.
You know? Like, I don't know anybody that's ever gotten in an accident because they were high, and I also don't. I don't think people should drive high. I think they should, you know, go around with Uber drivers who are all clearly high. They just don't do a show about it. Like, I don't want to run out and jump into a car right now. Everybody knows that's exactly what I'm doing.
Another bag.
Paranoia. It's weed paranoia kicking in. That pot topic was done, right? There it is. And we got a question from Morgan Murphy on Twitter. How did you like Vermont when you performed here? This is from Rarasaurus Rex. And did you manage to get stoned?
What an off-puttingly sincere question.
That was nice. I love Vermont. I was there
Right, that's Vermont. That's off-puttingly sincere should be their state, should be their campaign, you know, should be their tourism campaign.
Off-puttingly sincere.
Yeah, like you're just like, this is fantastic how nice everybody is.
Yeah, I must have gotten stoned. I pretty much get stoned every day, so I can't remember skipping a day. I managed to get. There's traveling's always weird because you're always like, I want to find pot, but I'm not going to pretend that I need to find pot. Like, I don't want to make people think I really need pot. It
doesn't stop. People already think I need pot, so I'm pretty covered. It's nice.
Let's
just put it out there. If Morgan Murphy comes to your town, just reach out, make it happen.
Reach out
and get big.
Sorry if I seem like a bitch when you talk to me.
Sorry if I just take the weed and say, get the fuck out of here. No, it's a nice way to meet up.
No good?
I met some nice people in Minneapolis, right, Geoff?
Yeah. I was outside Acme smoking a cigarette last night, and a homeless lady came up and barked the word cocaine at me. And I said, what? And then she said, cocaine? And I said, what again? And she said, do you have cocaine? And that was a very strange, no one just does that. What about anybody that looks like me, or you're like, I'm gonna fucking, if I yell at him, he'll probably give me his cocaine.
I think I know why she thought, was it a woman?
Yeah.
Why she thought you had cocaine.
Why?
Because there's so much of it in your beard. She thought there was cocaine in your beard. It was like, could you just snort your beard?
It just comes off.
That's how you get it through airport.
You really thought something was in your beard?
You told me there was cocaine in my beard. I thought the second half of the show was
going to
get a
little
weirder.
I wouldn't just be sitting here if there was cocaine in your beard. I'd be over there with my nose on your beard. I've never even tried it. Raise your hand if you've tried.
You've never snorted cocaine off a beard before?
Nuh-uh.
Oh, man.
Off of anything, not a mirror.
You've never done cocaine?
Not off of a stomach.
I've never done cocaine.
Never done coke?
Never?
Never.
Do you guys want to do my doing cocaine with Geoff? That's like it's a Periscope. It's only on Periscope.
Periscope.
Right, I found out what Periscope was right before the show started, and I fucking worked it in already.
Tucked it away.
Right? Good job, buddy.
Pete Holmes move.
Nicely done. Pete, what's your favorite thing to do? Johnny Hemp wants to know. What's your favorite thing to do when you're high? Johnny Hemp won. I apologize to Johnny Hemp.
I would never associate.
Johnny Hemp might be taking a lot of heat. Johnny Hemp won.
Johnny Hemp's family is like, we didn't know you had anything to do with marijuana.
Yeah.
Johnny Hemp won.
It is a question for everybody though, but I wanted to start with Pete because he was being very good and quiet down there.
Thank you, Doug.
Yeah, congratulations, Pete. You're a man.
You know, when I'm high, I like to do Getting Doug with High. It's an American podcast. Actually,
Obama's Pete. Doing it next week.
Reach out and
it's
duck face.
Amazing.
Why is your microphone louder than mine, Pete?
Mine has less air in it.
What if Obama was doing this podcast and then Doug was like, all right, hot topics, and then Obama doing like hot topics, like right here, like he knew everything about it. That'd be so great for you.
I think once he's out, I'd have a shot at getting him on. You know?
I think so.
True. Or maybe like the last 10 days.
I mean, but this has been a crazy descent. He's already, two guys that I know, colleagues of mine, have got to sit down with the president, and I'm assuming Maron's gonna fuck with him a little bit, and Zach fucked with him a lot. And it's the weirdest presidency ever.
Yeah.
For various reasons, but also the one I'm most proud of.
The Georgia Bush presidency was pretty weird too. It just wasn't as whimsical.
What do you like to do when you're high, Geoff? What do you like to do?
Honest to God, all I do stoned is watch Cheers.
I'm not even fucking kidding. Is that why you can watch it over and over again? Do episodes surprise you because
sometimes,
you're so high?
Well, what happens?
Oh, like, my God, Sam kissed her?
Only. That's like when he only kisses her, you're like, oh, he must like her.
How much, this is a great statistic that you may know. How many women, based on what he says, because they don't show it all the time, but how many women do you think Sam Malone banged in the course of that show?
100,000.
Total.
No, I can.
Not Chamberlain numbers, of course.
Yeah.
And as a side bet, lower or higher than actual Ted Danson?
Oh, interesting.
Oh, I think the actual Ted Danson.
He's been with Steenburgen for a while, so
and he
seems like a good dude.
Before that, and let's not assume the worst.
Oh my God! Wait, why did this turn into a gossip table show on VH1?
If I had to guess, I'd say it's around 500.
I was gonna, 500 seems right.
Wow!
Not during the show, like early
That's
on.
That's crazy. 500.
I think it's about 100 on the show, and. Oh, 400 before.
How many episodes do they do? Doesn't it always just start with like, man, Susie was a squirter?
No.
How often does he say something about twins? Because like Fonzie used to reference twins a lot, like he was fucking twins. But what about, did Sam ever have a twin encounter?
No, I think there was one where he slept with both, but not at the same time.
Yes, oh, played by the same actress? So because you didn't see her?
Most of the women he fucked on the show were never seen.
Just talked about.
Yeah. Or they would walk.
So maybe he's a huge liar.
For some reason, he could get some one night stand lady to walk him all the way to work and in the door and be like, "Oh, nice, see you later," and then she leaves and goes wherever. He's the fucking dude. Why is he getting walked to work?
Is he on the wagon through the whole series?
Yeah. He's drunk in one episode.
Because he falls off?
The beginning of season 3.
Is it good? Is that a good episode?
Yeah, I mean,
does he perform it well?
No, the way they show people drunk.
He's good at getting high on that Bored to Death show.
Is hilarious. He shows up at the bar barefoot, and he's got like a fedora on and his shirt's untucked, and he's like, I'm drunk. And that's it. That's how come he's drunk, is no shoes. Like, how do we convince people who are watching that he's drunk?
Because he'd never be walking around with no shoes on.
Yeah.
In Boston? Downtown Boston?
Yeah, that's crazy. He's drunk.
You get pulled over for a DUI in Boston, they just shine at your feet. He's good.
Well,
he's wearing shoes. Dude, I'm yes-anding you.
I don't think that's what happened.
You said drunk people don't wear shoes. And then I took
that
cheese.
Right.
I took that concept. These guys get it, man.
Yeah, no.
You're harshing my bag of faith.
I just stepped in Morgan's sense of humor. I don't know how I did that.
I think as a stoned comedian, you're half in your head and half listening, so half of the jokes your friends are saying are going to land, you know?
Just so not, what is not the answer? How many women did Ted Danson have sex with?
He says he thinks 500, and he's the only one that is anything close to an expert.
Wait, do you know the answer?
What do you mean? He watches Cheers all the time.
Oh, I got the feeling someone knew the answer.
I asked out of curiosity, not out of show-offiness.
Curiosity never built a skyscraper.
What?
I'm just saying nobody remembers the name of the guy.
You gotta look it up.
I'm gonna Google it.
He's Googling it.
Like a firework was coming at me.
You know, this is eventually what my breasts are gonna look like.
No! Don't say that.
I mind too.
Now you say what it looks like.
Oh, great.
To go.
That's just fun.
No, I was in Total Recall, remember?
You're right.
Total Recall?
I
remember that movie. Miles!
out his head. Like his head expands so much at the end of that movie and then goes back down and his skin is not all like flapping off. Like it just goes back to his normal face.
He should have been able to make a crazy wallet from his face.
Are you guys,
doing an impression of Colin Farrell? And then you get to smoke weed after you get
perfect
into an
solution.
I want
airbags.
To be right.
This is going to save Detroit.
Yes.
This idea. Because the first thing I wanted to do when my... Oh, shit.
Oh, shit.
The first thing I wanted to do when I had an airbag deployment.
Dude, it's going to be a weed sauna in like 2 seconds.
Like last year, Pete.
Did you say last year?
Last year. Right. But I was touching here, so then you probably thought tear. Because I was making a gesture of a tear, but I was just scratching my face.
Yeah.
But the bag deployed in the accident that I was in.
This is the airbag in Doug's car.
That's what I'm saying. You know Morgan made that joke 3 minutes ago?
You did?
Dude, there's like two shows happening.
And these guys Sit between the twins.
Don't call them the twins.
It's cool.
Thanks, all right, man. You're awesome. I stood up for you.
Fight for twins, man.
How you guys doing, Keith?
Still fucked up, man.
Kenny?
Yeah, same.
They're so alike. Oh, we're all twins up here tonight, man. This is everybody's really hot. I saw Junior recently.
Junior?
The Arnold Schwarzenegger pregnant thing.
That was a good one.
You like that?
I
talked you off of it right away.
It's
ridiculous, so it's kind of funny, but boy, is it awful.
Seahorses do not understand the premise of that movie.
Seahorses?
Is it based on the laughs? There were a couple people that got it.
That was a joke.
Wait, let's see. Can someone in the audience explain the seahorses thing?
He's talking about.
No, I'm asking someone out there. You said a few of them got it.
Yeah.
I think they laughed because it was a really weird non sequitur, but you think some of them got
it. I'm saying based on the quality of some of the laughs.
I don't think they did. I think they just enjoyed themselves. Who can explain it?
You can explain laugh it? Exactly how you just laughed.
He says he can explain it. This gentleman says he can explain it.
Go ahead.
Male seahorses
carry it.
Just say have the baby.
Stop trying to be technical.
They hold the baby to birth.
They hold the eggs. Penguins, the males do it too.
They have the baby.
Whatever. But what? That. So how's that a joke? When you said it?
Male seahorses don't get. What did I say? Don't get the concept of the movie Junior.
Because
to them it's normal.
Right.
It's just a different kind of movie. It's like a slice of life.
That's right.
It's like an indie.
It's like
Boyhood.
Boyhood.
Yeah, it's
Boyhood. That movie bombed.
If you're
the
seahorse.
Also, I'd like to say thank you and congratulations on getting my esoteric joke. Sorry I yelled at you.
Who'd you yell at?
I yelled at him like get into it.
Oh, the part about the baby, yeah.
Because I knew the more technical he was.
He was going eggs, you want a baby. You need a baby. You need a baby to make your case.
Hmm?
Nothing.
When you're on the
Why are you standing?
When you're on the end, it keeps coming back.
What?
Yeah. I'm here and I go, thank God, no more weed for a fucking dick.
It is a weird thing. We don't want to walk back and forth.
Yeah.
That's why Keith and Kenny are the most fucked up, I think. Yeah. It's because it just keeps hitting them going in every direction. Yeah.
They are twice as hot.
It's like a weed buffet, but it comes to you. It's like you can't, you know, we're not even.
Yeah. Golden bowl wrap.
Too lazy to even get our own weed.
Golden bowl wrap. Golden bowl wrap. Golden bowl around. If you don't have a golden bowl around, I mean, it's on you. Everything's there.
Okay.
Enjoy it. It's like a little laughter hobby kit. Just make it. Do your part.
I'm just thinking about, like, we have a lot of great merchandise on this show, and people need to, you know, be aware of it. So we're going to put up the where they can go to get the you can buy blue cards that some of us will sign after the show tonight.
I thought you just could buy them so you could do a version of this show at your house.
You could, yeah. You could, like that time Kramer had the Merv Griffin set. And
can we make a t-shirt that says Golden Bowl Round?
Yeah, we'll make a shirt that says that and put it up there with the regular shirt. And,
see you in a second.
And the very expensive mugs that we've been using. I do not recommend buying the mugs.
Hey.
And, and Geoff also is modeling something that you can purchase. Tell him about it, Geoff.
Oh, yeah, you can buy these shirts at zipzooapparel.com.
Zipzoo.
Yeah, it's a guy in Cincinnati
it's
makes
fun
these
to say.
Shirts.
Zipzoo.
And 25% of the sales goes to a domestic violence shelter in Cincinnati. So buy this.
That's how you do it. Mm-hmm. Give some money to a good cause, make some money, good for you. Pete Holmes, what's up? Why are you standing? What's going on?
Was that Janis Joplin?
Did you say hey, 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 hey? Thank you. Hey, hey, hey.
Why does that sound
I
wrong?
I say hey.
It sounds wrong.
What's going on? Turn into Marvin Martian.
Yeah, it sounds like Marvin Martian.
What's going on? I declare this stage in the name of me. Minion to Pete Holmes.
His bag has helium in it.
They got me.
Like...
Hilarious. How are we doing on time? What's
Can
going on with our time here?
Are we
getting close to a break?
Can the seahorse guy, can you explain the joke Golden Bull Rail? We were talking
no,
about...
No, there's no joke. He just keeps saying that.
Golden Corral. Golden Corral,
Bull Round.
He needs to be high to use Golden Corral, so it's a joke.
Oh, you added some logic to it.
He helped the album.
He helped
that one. That was a strong
was
assist
yes
there on that one. I'm going to blow some smoke in his direction because he deserves it.
It's like SeaWorld,
Golden
but with
Corral.
Smoke. Section.
Golden.
All right, you guys. When even Pete Holmes isn't jumping into the silence.
Oh, I thought I was gonna, but then I was like, take a beat, Pete.
Take a beat, Pete! That's the name of your sitcom. You
the
just always time. Step in it all the time. Just take a beat, Pete.
I like that the only time he takes a beat is when people stop talking.
Yeah, when I'm needed. Yeah. I'll also take a break.
Oh my God.
I thought we were going to swap seats more.
We could do that. We could do that. When we come back from the break, we'll swap and work out.
I thought the show was done.
No, no. And we got to get some more bags coming out. And
getting a strong feeling the show should be done.
Advertisers support the show and keep it free for you. We're running an audience survey to help us know more about Getting Dug with High listeners. Your answers help us find advertisers that are well-matched to you, your interests, and the show. That increases the chance of having happy advertisers, which means happy listeners. Everybody wins. Go to podsurvey.com/get-dug. It takes less than 5 minutes, and the survey is completely anonymous. When you're finished, you can enter your email for the chance to win a $100 Amazon gift card. We give away one gift card every month. Again, that's podsurvey.com/get-dug to take our survey and help the show.
Day.
You faded during my Shazam.
Pete, what's going on?
Don't fade on a man Shazam.
You're really, we told you it's called What's Going On by Four Non-Blondes.
And I didn't believe you. That's what Shazam is for.
Pete, that's the
Shazam!
Only, Pete, that's the only thing you don't believe. I've listened to your podcast. What we told you about Four Non-Blondes singing that song.
That's what I grew up.
Only thing you disagree with.
I'm gonna have to fact check that one.
Heaven and hell are real, but Four Non-Blondes? That doesn't sound
no
right.
No way. Up next, a scientist who will disprove the existence of Four Non-Blondes. My dad knows them.
1,668 people are watching us right now.
1,668?
Yeah.
Oh, If we got 30 more, we'd in the be archives, in the rough in, area where witches were being
played. Oh, okay. Good one. we'll get a lot more in the archive. It'll get up to about 200,000.
Oh, I wasn't eventually. Worried about the number. I was trying to think of a joke for the year.
No, no, I was going to say that, and then you said something, and then I tried to go back to what I was trying to say.
Okay, I was worried that you thought I was like, why am I wasting my time with 1,600 people?
No, dude, I just, you totally.
That, because that's a good amount of people.
No, I love it. I hope they love it.
Do you think Darth Vader like, is still doing okay?
What's that?
Do you think Darth Vader washes it out? Like, do they open him up and spray him down once a week?
Well, he's got to. I mean, the helmet clearly comes off. You see that.
Helmet comes off. You have to assume that, like, part of the leg comes off. He's like,
yeah, they probably have to do some routine maintenance, you know, like anything.
Yeah. No Quaker State.
You know. Good question, Pete.
Thank you.
I've got one for you from Twitter. Does Pete Holmes suspect any of his NBA buddies are secret stoners?
Oh.
And this is Ian Jacoby wants to know.
Yeah, I mean, wouldn't you smoke some dope if you were just dunking basketballs all day?
Oh, wait. I'm sorry, I didn't read his whole name. Ian Jacoby TMZ is his name. So look for that story on there on Monday.
Well, who just dropped weed, right? Someone dropped weed outside of a club.
Dropped weed? The new album
club.
Weed?
Yeah, I don't know.
When does it drop?
Am I crazy that it was Durant, or am I making a lot? Am I
who knows?
Defaming?
No, it could be. Somebody dropped
an NBA player dropped some pot outside a club, and it was.
I want to put out an album.
Apparently not big news.
No, we're sorry. I thought you were done, Morgan. I'm sorry.
No.
I want to put out an album called My Balls, so when I do press, I can be telling everyone when my balls are going to drop.
How many times do you think you told that joke?
This show?
No, in life.
That was the first time.
That was locked and loaded. I've heard that before.
That wasn't locked and loaded.
Really? You just made that up?
My balls is going
to
drop.
Yeah, I know. I'm trying to fix that.
My balls is going to drop.
I've been smoking Benson grade marijuana.
I don't know what that is. But it seems to be working. I think it'd be fun at this point in the show to say, let's do a pot quiz hop shot.
Pot quiz, there it is.
Weed etiquette, you guys. Do you think, how much do you think you know about weed etiquette?
That song sounds.
I feel
like
the excitement about this. It's really crazy how into it you are. Pete, do you know anything about weed etiquette?
I just want to say the music you play for this segment sounds like the holding music for the pilot of Seinfeld. Like before it got picked up. Like they don't have the money to go out to the guy that can do the boom ba dum, so they just play it again.
Kramer! Isaac Kessler!
That was good. He was called Kessler in the pilot. Jesus.
Pete's pop culture knowledge is very specific and insanely random.
You didn't know he was called Kessler in the pilot? George was a stand-up?
No, I did know that. I'm just saying that, see how you're going off about it? And then something else from the same time period, you don't even know that exists.
Oh, that's true and valid. Isn't that just the feeling of life? You know something, and others, you don't.
I think we've had the same conversation before when we were high. Because
that might have been when I made that my balls drop joke.
Yeah, how many circles have you told that joke, Kate?
Just the flat one. So.
Oh, thank you.
More weed.
Is it really hot in here?
So take off all your clothes.
I am getting hot, so I'll do what you said.
These aren't the droids you're looking for. Yeah. You know, when you're in a club with the ladies, if you just tell them you got to take it off because it's hot, they go, okay, well, that makes sense.
Now that he mentions it, I am toasty these and very
the,
horny.
These aren't the droids we were looking for.
I was looking for sweatpants before I came. Yeah. It sounds like I would be making fun of you, but like, I like it.
Big fan, sweatpants.
Right?
They're great.
I almost wore sweatpants tonight, and I thought, I should dress up.
Dress up for the stoner talk show?
Yeah.
I know what you're talking about. Do you feel that you get too much of a dick outline?
Yes, I do.
No, I don't think so.
And let's talk about it.
MorganMurphy.com.
That's a real, like, oh, I, you know, mom, please, you know, one of those.
Will you stand up and show us what kind of bulge we're looking at?
Yeah.
All right, I didn't know he'd actually do it. I was going to try to just move on.
Yeah. You don't get this.
That's just a crease.
Please sit down. He's just like, his brain is just in a constant search for a reason to stand up.
That'd be a good thing to do as like a boy growing up, is like the way that you mark your height on a wall, just mark down your leg, your dick.
That's a great tattoo.
Yeah.
7, 9, 12. But then you're naked at that point, so they can tell it's not true.
But what if it was true?
What if it were true?
Here, let me stand between you here for a second.
Pete,
this is one that Tony Kameen taught me that it's fun to do to the ladies, but I'm going to do it to you because I'm a gentleman.
Okay, ready?
He taught me you do this. You go up to a woman and you say, "What state am I thinking of?"
I don't know.
There's 50 of them.
Oh.
Just name one of them.
Rhode Island.
See if we're connected in any way. Which one?
Rhode Island.
No.
And if I imagine that being Tony Kameen's face that close, more terrifying.
Sure, I didn't mean to throw him under any buses. I just wanted to do his funny bit.
I'll throw him under a bus.
Okay.
Let's play a game, a new segment called Throw Him Under the Bus. And I'll name someone when we just kind of say something that you wouldn't normally say.
I fucking love it. Let's go. Here we go. I kept one card just in case. Let's go. Let's do it. Who has to go first? You have to go first.
Oh, I'm not playing. I'm the moderator.
That is a great idea for the show. Pete takes over.
Bob takes over.
So we're not going to play that game.
I just can't think of a good name. I mean, we could do fictional people.
Here's a weed etiquette. Here's a weed etiquette question, Pete.
Yeah.
Yeah. Focus on this.
Focus on the family.
Focus on the family that smokes weed together and gives their children marijuana cookies. Cookies! If you bring pot to a party, Pete.
Yeah, pot party.
If Pete brings pot to a party.
A potluck.
You could call it that.
I can't be any better.
If Pete brings pot to a potluck.
Uh-huh.
Can you take it with you when you leave?
Not publicly. If you see a small amount and you're wearing a baggy short, feel free to sit on it and clench. No one will be the wiser.
And then it's nice and ground up when you get home.
Yeah.
You can roll one up.
You don't have to buy one of those little grinders if you have an ass.
Yeah. Go through customs, roll a J right out of your butt. I love it.
So I'm going to say no. Same with wine.
Huh?
Even if it's unopened, I think you have to leave it.
Gotta leave
Once it passes the threshold, it's like I'm allowed to shoot you and keep your wine.
This is how wise you are. The first few words are, just like with alcohol.
We smoked ecstasy, yeah?
Why, you getting kind of touchy-feely? Or that's more like a...
Don't tell me how to do ecstasy.
That's more of an LSD thing, I think, that's happening to you.
If you did this on LSD, you'd die.
Why?
Because it would look like a wormhole, and you'd be like, all right. But really, it was just like a wood chipper. You Fargoed yourself.
Question for Morgan Murphy.
Yes.
Is it rude to decline pot at a party?
No. It's not rude to decline pot at a party.
That is correct.
What if you don't smoke pot?
Never feel obligated.
Thank you.
I think that's a great rule for everything that I do in life.
Yeah.
Don't feel obligated. If you want to get involved, whatever. But
nobody did it. Round of applause if you thought it was rude to decline pot.
Anyone?
That's a hard, that's a hardcore pot smoker or someone that just flipped in the question in her head because she's really high. I assume it was a lady. Why did you like why did you clap?
Oh,
it's a dude. The reason I clap like a lady is because
it was a polite
Father's
clap.
Day's tomorrow. What?
It was a polite clap.
Yeah. Why'd you clap?
It's like somebody offers
Yeah, I guess so, but like I'll say no to, you know, cake or whatever.
I say no to food too.
But what if you're like a vegetarian and they offer you meat?
Exactly.
And then you say, oh no, thank you. I don't eat meat. Then you
smoke the pot. Yeah, smoke the pot first and then you eat the meat.
I only eat cake. I only eat cake if it was smuggled in a file.
Oh shit.
Yeah. How long ago was that? Callback wise.
That was such a pretty good callback, it was rotary.
I'm telling you, like you could do a pot Cirque du Soleil, where one of the numbers is a bunch of fairies throwing around these bags.
I thought you were falling.
Taking big ass hits. I was kind of falling, yes.
Hey, Jeff, clap like a man. Clap, and I'll tell you what gender your clap is.
Well, I just meant it was soft. It was like almost like golf clapping or something.
Oh, I wasn't attacking you. I just think there's different types of femininity and different types of masculinity.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not going to clap for you. I'm also, if you said run across the stage, I wouldn't do that either, you know?
I'll do it.
Okay.
I wasn't taking you to task. I thought it would be a fun game.
No, I get it. I get it.
Like, Morgan, you clap. I'm going to close my eyes and see if it's really you. That was you.
You were good at that.
Very good.
Okay, now close your eyes. Close your eyes.
Just clap.
Close your eyes.
Go ahead.
Yeah, I'm gonna have somebody clap, and then you have to guess their first name. Close your eyes.
Can we get a?
You have to guess their first name. Close your eyes.
Your name is.
You can't do that. Just do it.
All right, then I'm gonna say left and right. Left and right.
Their first name. You can do it. Just concentrate.
All right. I forget who's on the show. Geoff Tate. Geoff.
That's correct.
Yeah! Make a GIF! You can tell the internet to make GIFs. Yeah, watch this. Make a GIF. But we should use something that they could use. You know what I mean? Like.
What?
Like, we agree.
All right, let's do it.
We agree.
Then right, then friend. They have an argument. They could say, Pete Holmes and one of the Lucas brothers agree with me, and then show them the thing. That's brilliant.
Yeah.
Good
and then
job.
Just in case they say something like, I thought the Nazis were okay. We agree.
I was going to say, we don't agree, but you did the bit.
Wait, which two are the twins?
You feel like we all just met, and I kind of bonded a little bit more with him.
Now, Pete Holmes, I have a...
We agree.
I have an important question for you, Pete. The game is over.
What game were we playing?
It's the Listen to Pete game. And,
I love that game.
But now you have to concentrate. I know that magic is hard on you.
I love magic.
Okay.
Present thine magic.
All right, here he comes. It's game time.
Feels a lot longer than
here he is over there. Look that way. Oh, wait, here he comes. Pete, look out.
What? Is this the broken bottle thing? Hey! 420 vision.
All right, I've got all these classic movies and beloved movies, little tiny posters here.
Glasses, right?
Geoff, I'm going to have you take those and find a movie that you like. Doesn't have to be your favorite. Just choose one. Everybody can participate in this if they want.
Have people made the joke 420 vision before, or is that just not a good joke?
I think it's in the middle. What do I do with it?
Okay, cool. There's a list on the back.
Hold on, I'm trying to do it. Fucking magic.
You don't have to do it.
No, I'm involved, man, and it's magic. I want to fucking know what's happening.
He's right.
There's a list on the back, so turn it over to that so you can see that. All right, I want you to read through the list. Each person can read a name if they want, and just in any order that you'd like, as long as you say them all, and go for it anytime.
Jaws. Guys, there's a lot of them. This is going to take a while.
E.T. the Extraterrestrial.
Toy Story.
Annie Hall.
Populous Now.
Titanic.
Forrest Gump.
The Matrix. It's a Wonderful Life.
Fargo.
Titanic.
High Noon.
The Matrix.
Jaws.
Can we say King Kong? Nightmare on Elm Street.
Oh, he said it. National Lampoon's Vacation. Taxi Driver. You already said that. Oh, okay.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, I think we've said them all.
All right. Is it Jaws?
Is it Jaws? Yeah, it's Jaws.
It's Jaws. Jaws, man.
That's very great. Thanks,
guys. Oh, man. How you doing?
I really wanted to smash a bottle on Pete's head during that, but I couldn't go through with it.
Do you have it?
Yeah, let's hear it for peace. It doesn't hurt that much. It doesn't hurt. Gabe says it doesn't hurt.
Peace. Did you say peace or Pete's?
Peace.
Like,
peace.
Let's give it up for Pete's, all of them.
Trying to think of a Pete I don't like.
Peter Rose.
Peter Pan is a...
Hey,
he's like Peter Pan?
He's a little cocky.
Not Pete Rose.
Peter Rose.
No, Pete Rose is an asshole. Right?
Oh, okay, so that was
there you go.
One?
Yeah. Pete Rose.
Is Petey Pablo, does he count as a Pete?
Yeah, he counts as a Pete.
Oh, yeah.
Anytime you identify, we accept you into the community.
Peter Guns.
Peter Guns is cool.
I like him. Peter Guns. I'm just trying to think of a Peter.
I'm going to start trying to do your plugs.
That's a dick.
Because it's going to be hard to get through them.
Peter's mean dick.
Pete Holmes.
What's happening?
You're going to be at the American Comedy Company in San Diego.
Yep.
I'm going to be down there later, or a couple days before you.
Oh, shit. We miss each other?
Yep. But you're going to do the You Made It Weird podcast at that club. That's going to be really fun, Thursday, July 9th.
Yep.
So if you're at Comic-Con or just live in San Diego, go check it out.
Yep.
Yeah.
Montreal, too. They're on PeteHolmes.com.
Yeah, Pete Holmes, everybody.
For the plugs.
Lucas Brothers, Keith and Kenny, their sketch show, Friends of the People, season 2, premiere on July 16th at 10:30 on True TV.
Oh, yeah.
It does. Right? Is that right?
Yeah. That's right.
I think so.
And Lucas Brothers Movie Company airs Thursdays on FXX's Animation Domination High Definition.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm glad people are finding FXX, because at first I was like, that's just not going to work.
A lot of people. But.
Yeah, it's awesome. You guys are great. Great job on the show. That was incredible. You too, Pete. And Morgan Murphy, of course. Morgan Murphy, you can see that face right there. It's her cover of her special. I see it every time I'm on Netflix. And it's also on iTunes and Amazon. It's called Irish Goodbye. So get that, Morgan Murphy.
Thank you.
Another great smoker. Geoff Tate, how are you?
I'm stoned. I'm very, very fucking stoned.
I thought you said Sauron. That's how stoned I am. That's a new level of stone when you can only describe how high you are referencing movies that are great to watch while high.
I love how you always hear things wrong, but you hear them into a funny thing you can talk about. Whenever you mishear somebody, it's funny.
What you didn't say reminds me of something.
Yeah. Jeff's going to be a go-bananas. Did you mention apricots? Because... Go Bananas in Cincinnati. Love that club. July 9th through the 12th. Have you guys ever played there, any of you? Go Bananas in Cincinnati? Let's sign you all up. You're going to love it.
All right.
Yeah, so good.
Signed up.
And Geoff, of course, also has a podcast about Cheers because he's seen every episode 300 times. And he knows that Sam Malone has banged 500 ladies. Happy Father's Day tomorrow, everybody. And the show's called Afternoon, Everybody. And it's available on iTunes. And he's also got a big tour coming up this fall, so... Go follow Geoff Tate. What's your Twitter thing?
Geoff Tate, 96.
Yeah, and you guys today, if you want to purchase his CDs, he'll be hanging around outside in the lobby.
Yeah, I need to make space on my suitcase.
Yeah, okay. So that sounds like their price to move.
The price to move. So it's literally by. An overstock sale.
Yeah.
I think that my balls album might be a Zach joke.
Really?
Yeah.
It really seemed familiar to
me. Yeah, I think it's a, I think, I apologize. That's an existing riff.
You know what, we'll just cut, we'll do some edits, and we'll take you out of this episode. 10 minutes, I wonder if it'd be more than that.
I wish you weren't the bit coach so that the bit coach could yell at you.
That would be perfect.
For stealing a bit.
How dare you? But the bitch coach just
but don't give Pete both parts.
He already had both parts.
Was that everybody? Oh, my plugs. I gotta do my plugs. Where'd they go? Oh no. I'm gonna be at one place and another place. Philadelphia at Helium, that's Wednesday, June 24th. Denver Comedy Works, July 5th at 4:20. Denver. And also, you could see that movie that we showed the trailer for earlier, Chronicon. I'm going to show it at the Alamo Drafthouse in Denver on July 3rd at midnight. So if you're in Denver and don't have big 4th of July plans, come to that. Irvine, California, the Improv on Tuesday, July 7th. DougLovesMovies.com for all of my dates and deets and links. Let's hear it for everybody on the stage for doing so well. The next episode is going to be Tuesday, June 23rd at 1:15 Pacific time. And I know who the guests are, and if they don't cancel, it'll be great. So thanks, and thanks to the audience for coming in and watching us do this, watching this social experiment. And we'll see you on this very Tuesday. We'll see you Tuesday. See you. Bye.